10 tape. This introduces 4 years of fun, frolic and games with a little bit of academic brilliance in between. We've had a good time over the last 4 years, and hopefully this tape will bring back some of those memories and some of the friendships that you've made over those years. And we've got a lot of things to do in the future, the next 2 years, and hopefully we can do it together and do it as well as we can. I've really enjoyed the last 4 years. I know I'm going to enjoy the next 2 years because I've made some very good, long-lasting friendships amongst a lot of kids in Year 10, and I regard them as being a really great bunch of people.
Now we're here.
45 very capable students to go out to Fitzroy Falls Monday and Tuesday, to undergo further training.
Mm-hmm. And further therapy.
Further therapy, and good times, hopefully. Right.
And a big night tomorrow night?
A big night tomorrow night. I just hope it's not too big. Right. I've seen some evidence in the past of what can happen, so just take it easy. Mm-hmm. Enjoy yourselves, but just remember there's always tomorrow.
Okay. Righto.
And there is no truth in the rumour that has been going around the school that I have a bald spot.
No truth whatsoever.
No truth.
I rode her off for the chance of the day. Practiced all the things I would say. She came over, I lost my nerve. I took her back.
Bit hot.
We're doing the kitchen now.
I don't know. Everybody.
Everybody? Oh, come on, the legends of Year 10.
I don't know. Me.
Oh, thanks very much. People are going to agree with that. Right, which teachers do you think are the teachers that are living in your memory?
Mr. Malone, definitely.
Definitely, yes.
Year advisor. That's a hard one. Mr. Welsh.
Yeah. Why is that?
One of the most disliked teachers.
Oh,
I'm in front of the TV. Matthew, we're on the floor. We're on the floor. As Danielle.
Tiffany.
As Danielle. We're on the floor. There's five chairs. We're on the floor. Okay, we're sitting on the floor eating.
Danielle.
And another
one. Who are the legends of your floor?
Give a kennel for...
Of what? Of your kennel. Year 10.
Me. I don't know.
We're trying to concentrate on the issue of who are the personalities of your four.
Me.
I'm a
big award yesterday, a big scholarship.
I'm going to Wollongong Uni to study engineering, which of course I don't want to do.
Yeah.
But I got the award for it anyway.
At the same time.
I'm going to be a Mathis chick all my life.
I'm going to become a teacher, a primary school teacher.
Primary school teacher.
Hey, Johnny Love, man.
Yeah.
Who else? I'm going to be kindergarten.
And if you were going to have bad memories, does BOWRAL bring any bad memories for you?
Yeah. Oh, of course. course. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
When I'm saying on camera, who does it to
Bad memories.
Would include most
bad memories.
Year 7.
The year seven disco for sure.
Year seven disco was the one for year seven or the year seven one that
you had? Yep. It was just a year seven disco. I just remember it as the year seven disco.
We had the year six.
Eleanor won the prize for the dance.
It's Ninja Turtle.
Ninja Turtle.
I'm calling Ninja Turtle.
We talk about it.
Which one were you?
That's how I knew you were.
Michelangelo. Michelangelo, you should have been Donatello.
What are the others?
I was Raphael. Leonardo, okay. Raphael,
well,
Michelangelo,
very
Donatello.
Much like right, yeah.
Very welcome.
Who are the legends of year 10?
Yeah.
Who are the legends?
Yeah.
Who? Wheezy?
What?
Wheezy?
Weezer.
Oh, Weezer. Oh. Really? Do you have trouble with spring?
Yep.
Allergies. Okay. Is this what was the whole idea here?
You can explain.
Simon.
Tracy.
We've got to make our house.
Got to make your house.
Yep.
Draw a house.
House plan. And what is this?
This is our house.
You're kidding. It looks like a.
Not as good as the one on the wall. That one's better. That's a better one on there.
Here we've got a wave pool.
Yeah.
And we've got a normal swimming pool outside with a 10-story slippery dip, and it's got an elevator going to the top of it.
Right.
And we've got a spa, a bar.
Yeah. Spa bar.
Air hockey.
Right.
Pool, table tennis.
So the whole emphasis of your design is just leisure and pleasure.
Yeah,
is it?
And we've got a cinema here so we can make some money, a gym so we can get big and muscly.
This is not a home. It's an absolute leisure centre.
This is like
a sleeping room.
It's like a sleeping pit, sort of. It's like this.
Oh, right. It's sort of sunken into the ground.
Sort of like an orgy room or something.
Oh, with lots of orange juice.
And here, in the bathroom, we've got those.
Hang on, I can't focus on it. It's getting hot.
In the bathroom, we've got those toilet things. So you can like stand up, you don't have to aim or anything.
Right.
You can sit on the wall.
That's if you're a male.
And we've got ones for the squatters as well.
Do you appreciate that, ladies, you're taking in like that?
Yeah.
What do you think?
It's all right.
It's all right? Yeah. Okay. The squatters.
We've got the homebrew room and the greenhouse so we can be self-sufficient with the vegetables and all that.
Yeah. There's one room missing.
What?
And don't you guys eat?
A kitchen.
Oh, the kitchen bar sort of place.
Oh, the kitchen greenhouse.
See, we've got everything.
There are some faults with
we've
that.
We've got everything.
Maybe you'll work it out.
This is backyard.
The backyard. Right, tell me.
Helicopter. We've got
the helicopter pad, yep.
We've got the castle.
Jumping castle.
Bus.
Are you guys serious? Like
tennis
crop. Yeah. And what's that?
A crop.
Oh.
Tomato plants
and other green things. With leaves.
I see. And we're going to have a bar. We've got a barmaid. That's
important. A barmaid?
A barmaid, yep.
What?
Without tits.
Awesome. Serious. Okay, Simon, tell me, over the years that you've spent at BOWRAL Home, who are the people that make Year 10 outstanding for? I mean, I've just
Mr. Malone, yes.
Okay. I've been speaking to some Year 9 people, and all they reckon about you guys is you're the form X. You know, no character.
No, we haven't, actually.
You're just made up of, what do they call you? Boonies. Boonies or Booners?
Booners.
That's the one. Do you agree?
Oh, yeah, just... He
says, "That's
great, Simon." Oh, no, we're original. We're not like the rest. We don't have to, you know,
go for patterns.
Yeah.
All right. Well, you've got people like Kurt Watts, for example.
Yeah, that's me.
Okay. Deputy principal.
Yeah.
Another idea.
If they want to call us Booners, they can't come to our formal party.
Fair enough.
Yeah, right. Year 9 isn't supposed to be there anyway.
Right. Well, no, that's it. They're out of bounds.
So it's year 10 or older.
Okay. All right. Kurt, we'll go over here into the corner. Kurt.
Nice hair here.
Well, he's going to Vietnam. He's got it. Kurt, teacher that's impressed you over 4 years.
What?
Teacher that's impressed you over 4 years.
Mr. Chuckarelli.
Mr. Chuckarelli. Well, he can speak for himself.
There hasn't been.
All right. Well, on the other side of things, who are the teachers that have absolutely drilled you to boredom?
Mr.
Arkives. Good choice.
Yeah,
that's about it. Okay, coming over to, what's your name again?
Amy.
I was going to call her Amber.
Amy from Queensland.
Yes.
Oh.
Edition.
You've come late. Which year did you join us?
9.
Year 9?
Yeah.
Okay. Have you enjoyed the swap? Changeover? Sort of?
Yeah.
Go on, be honest. What do you think of New South Wales people?
They're alright.
They don't say that.
Hey.
Yeah. Hey. They're alright, hey.
They're pretty good.
Alright,
pretty
good.
Okay.
In a styler.
Alright. Who were some teachers that impressed you over the last 2 years?
None.
None again? Oh, right. So who are your worst teachers?
So what exactly
did
you
not
say about
it?
Mr. Morgan.
Oh, yeah, you remember that art teacher Mrs. Ramsey?
And Mrs. Ramsey
has impressed. She's the best teacher.
Yeah. Alright, well, we'll have your say now.
Why do you like Mrs.
O'Brien hated? Mrs. O'Brien. Miss O'Brien.
Yeah.
You didn't like her.
No,
well, you thought she was a legend.
She had a tattoo.
Yeah. She had a tattoo.
She had one on her shoulder, but she didn't show us where the other one was.
It was her.
Okay.
She was a good teacher.
She was a good teacher, right.
Yeah.
Who are the other teaching legends? Come on, we can do this a general way around, Dan, you can say.
Mr. Statch. Mr. Erskine's pretty funny.
Yeah, yeah. Mr. Statch.
Bit old fashioned.
Mrs. Brennan, she's
a prehistoric.
Oh, you enjoy Mrs. Brennan?
No.
That's coming out there. Okay, so you go for those Thatchers type. Okay, excellent. And what are the others that come into your calculations as legend?
Oh, Mrs. Cameron.
Yeah.
Miss Sands.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You have a. Have anybody else noticed that it's all Miss, Mrs., Miss,
yes.
Mrs.? Yeah.
Miss Malone. Miss
Malone.
Mr. Malone. Yeah. All right.
Which people do you reckon, student-wise, are the legends of your four?
Oh, me.
Who was that?
Nothing.
Kylie.
No, nothing. Yeah.
I agree.
Brendan Gamala.
Right, well, listen. I think we're in. Who was it?
Brendan Gamala.
Brendan Gamala. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. I saw him at the dance party. I mean.
He
made it. What about him yesterday? What happened yesterday?
Oh, that's pretty funny.
Well, what happened?
I know.
I don't know. That's why I'm asking.
It's gone round.
All right, Brendan, you know what we're talking about, but they're not going to tell me. All right. Well, we are in the presence of a legend, Marty Smarty.
Marty.
Okay, Marty, who else amongst your Year 10 peers are legends?
Me.
Oh, yeah, thank you, Joyce.
Yep.
None.
Noah?
No.
They don't come up to scratch?
No.
You reckon you agree with Year 9? All boons?
No.
No, we're not boons.
Far from it.
We're legends.
Legends.
Oh, well.
All right.
Yeah.
Then. Now, I just have to capture this. This is a moment. They've got into the lollies.
Oi! Awesome. Simon,
okay, Mr. Malone, these are the people that took them.
There you
are. Oh, dear. And these are the two innocent guys that didn't touch them. These guys here. All right? And now they're getting incriminated. Anyone else want to make a comment? Mr. Woods?
No.
No? Anyone here?
Yeah, what were the Year 9 saying?
Oh, just the fact that they thought you were, you know,
we're
pretty
cool.
Out of it.
Our step gang, we're pretty cool.
Yeah.
We do the Year 10 thing, throw the kids' balls away.
Alright, yep. That gives you a right to legendhood.
Yep.
Okay.
Didn't you ask any of the other years?
No, well, we'll do some interviews with them and see what they think.
Hang on.
Yep.
I'm leaving.
Yeah.
And I say it's going to be just heaps good fun. And at school, the Bow High's the best.
Well, you notice that there's a certain resource low in.
They've been into the lobby.
Oh well.
They thought they were.
It was Zombie and Cruz.
Yeah, it was these two over here. They got straight into them and shared them out.
Oh, did they? Well, a bit of initiative doesn't go astray, does it?
Well, the idea is to work as a group to create an object that will fly from the top of the balcony up there the furthest distance.
Have they got a time limit on this?
Well, they've got about 3 minutes left at the moment.
All right. Well, I must measure the results. I'll be there to film this.
Okay then.
Okay, I'll just go around and see what they're coming up with. What are the principles being employed here, gentlemen? Ladies?
Thank you.
Yes?
Just making? Making it fly.
Making it fly?
Build it and see if it flies, and if it doesn't, we've got to rebuild it.
Has this been a team effort?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Has it?
Yes.
You don't look like you've made any contribution at all.
This is the only thing I can do.
Sticky holder.
Sticky first.
Yeah, the sticky holder. They're important.
Okay, well, should we stick that together? Or
just
stick on there?
All right.
Okay. What chance do you give yourselves here with this model that we'll call the Concorde?
It's got a
big nose, isn't it?
Like sticky gel like that.
No, like getting little bits and putting it across.
Listen guys, I'm just also briefly, this is your year 10 video, okay, in the making.
Alright.
Could you tell me, who are the people that make your form a sort of legendary year? Like, are there
Simon
personalities?
Yeah,
Simon Wall? Yeah. Any other legends? You can always say me, but everybody goes, yeah.
Oh, do you want to tear it?
Mr. Malone.
Mr. Malone,
here.
Yeah, any other teachers that are...
Jethro Leavers.
Jethro Leavers is awful, yes. He is a legend.
He's annoying.
Yeah, 1 minute to go.
Dylan's a legend.
Dylan is. Oh yeah, I'd agree with that. Well, what about teachers? Are there legendary teachers that you've passed in your years here?
Just Mr. Malone. Mr. McGowan's alright.
Mr. McGowan's okay.
Oh, yeah, we love you, Mr. McGowan. You're
a
favourite teacher.
Before he left. Mr. Miller, right on the science stuff. Yep.
Quiet.
Okay, well, I'll keep moving around and see what we can.
Oh, we're just about to start the plane flying. Oops.
Guys, can I just see your plane?
That's a bit of a warp jalopy.
A warp jalopy, is it?
Yeah, but.
Okay, how far are you?
We think it should get halfway.
Halfway?
Yeah.
Across the hall?
Yeah, we're
you serious?
Yeah, yeah.
All right.
Power.
What do you think? Is he just dreaming?
Yeah.
Well.
Look at little Mahomes. Hello. I can find the love I want. Someone better slap me before I start to rust, before I start to decompose. Disappear. I can make it disappear. Have no fear. I like fantasy spike with pain, and music is my aeroplane. It's my aeroplane. Songbird, sweet and sour chain, and music is my aeroplane. It's my aeroplane. Pleasure spike.
Who was in it?
Me and John.
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 And
okay.
And me.
And Tracy.
She just watched.
And Jethro.
Yep.
But Jethro made his own little fella.
That's an illegal one made out of something else.
Oh, out of that other paper. Listen, who are the legends of your four?
Of our four?
Yeah, Alice. Tell us, isn't it?
Yep.
Okay. Who do you believe are the characters of the four?
Probably John.
John,
Murray.
Murray, yep. Yeah. Why? What makes him a legend?
Because he just made our plane win.
Fair enough, okay. But in other ways? Extraordinary guitar player?
Yeah.
Great sense of humour?
Yeah.
Okay. Great intellect? Okay. Who are the teachers that you've enjoyed having over the years?
Miss Jad's been good.
Yep.
Miss Collette.
Right, okay.
And...
Do you have a precious memory of your years at BOWRAL? Any great event that stands out amongst others?
Superfuzz Big Muff.
The Superfuzz Big
yep.
Muff? Superfuzz Big Muff?
Yep.
Why was it so big an event? Why did you enjoy it so much?
Oh, because
I... Because of this guy up there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the unlegend of you two.
He's calling you an unlegend. Are you going to take that from him? You punish him later, Alice.
Okay.
Okay.
Yep.
Well, thanks for your opinions.
Okay. Okay. Bye.
You gotta keep them separated.
Like a brain disease, we can't stop it all the way.
separated.
Hey! Man, you disrespect me! Take them off!
You gotta keep them separated.
Opinion of the group?
I'd say they were a little bit immature because the first group, they
Isn't that just typical of year 10?
The dummy, kicked it, because the others were losing. Don't take
you guys are just losing.
Somebody tore all the paper up, so we, they crumpled it all up and we couldn't use it properly.
And he's disappointed because he couldn't
haven't you guys got a union bone in your body? Are you just full-time losers? Alright, just quickly. Just quickly, who are the legends of year 10?
Yes.
That's a legend? That's a legend? That's a legend? How come you guys can only sort of say me? What can't you think of anybody else?
Miss Stroud. Miss Stroud.
Alright, teacher legends.
Kylie Dowd is a legend.
Did you realise that?
No, I didn't realise
that. Alright.
Kylie
Dowd, why? What does she have?
Qualifications?
She's got
Angie and Donna.
Biggest mouth.
Angie and Donna are our family.
Right. Anyone else? Anyone else?
Angie and Donna. Angie
and Donna
Greg.
Yes. Anyone else?
Angie, Greg and Donna
Greg. Belinda Bunter, which
Belinda Bunter. Legend.
Bunter, she's always
made all the money in Rochester.
Okay. At your formal tomorrow night.
Yeah.
If you had to give an award to the top rating female student, who would it be? Who are the contenders?
What do you mean, as in?
Oh, you know, most popular.
Very popular.
Who would it be?
I think I'd
get
bitch of the year.
Not a year 10 student.
April
Dean.
Would get most popular, yes.
Would she?
Yes.
Okay, male. Male personality. Maybe not.
Nick Merriman.
Nick Merriman would be.
Would be a ticket.
I'd give bitch of the year to Heath.
Bitch of the year. Ooh, that's a little severe.
That's awful.
Okay.
But anyway, I've done it without Amy.
Thanks for your candidness. Any teachers that you want to basically mention as legends? Murdo.
Where is
it? Miss Kanchan?
Yeah.
Fluffy is her nickname, is it?
Mr. Stats.
What's his nickname?
I reckon Mr. Malone's a legend.
Stats-o. Let's get it right. Any other
Mr. Malone's a legend. I think it's good that he's looking after your skin and putting cream on his ball patch. So good on him.
Well, we'll put that myth to rest. He's not bald. You know what bald is?
I didn't want to see that.
Sorry? Coming to the formal. This is your formal take in the process.
Miss Tate. Mr. Mallard. Yes. You should come to the afterparty.
Are you playing this?
Yeah.
Come to Belmont.
Miss Stroud's coming. She's bringing a keg.
Mrs. What?
No, I'm not.
Have you got a ball? Have you got a ball spot? That you?
No.
Yes. Okay. We've all got ball patches somewhere. If you look hard. Not a whole lot happening here, no? Is this the working end here?
Yeah. Oh no, we've just done it because we're so good.
You finished the activity,
right? We're the fastest group to ever do it.
Ever.
In the peer support history.
What's the group? What was the activity?
It was called Robin Hood. Us group members.
Yeah.
To rank characters in the following story.
Yes.
Being one, the most objectionable, and five, the least.
Least objectionable.
Yeah.
And you found Robin Hood to be the most objectionable.
Yeah, because it's sort of like a different story. And
so what did he get to do? Did he molest your 10 students?
He tried, but he tried. he hit Marion and called her a harlot.
Really?
He slept. Yeah, he's
I mean, that's an Australian sport. Wife bashing, isn't it? Fairly acceptable, I would have thought. What is going on here?
Who's taking photos of you? Taking
photos of me. Oh, is he? Listen, guys, I'm just going around and trying to find, this is your year 10 take. Now, year 9 doesn't believe you guys, as a year, have any character.
Don't have any character.
They actually call you boomers.
Boomers? rumours.
Can you believe that?
Yes, well, who are the people that make your form have character? Who are the characters of your form?
Characters in our form.
Yes. Characters in our form.
Like, who are the legends?
Gordo.
Gordo.
Yeah, okay, there's a character. Who's Gordo?
Right. We're just laden with them. I wouldn't be able to
get it into the 3-hour film that we got.
No, I wouldn't.
Okay. Listen, anyone else? What we're discussing down this end is Year 9 has thrown cast aspersions on your name. They feel Year 10, 1995, is the most colourless, characterless bunch of booners that ever existed or walked the planet. Do you think they've pretty much got it under the wraps?
Yeah.
That's pretty much it, isn't it? Who are the characters of your form? Kylie, your name's been mentioned a few times. Do you know why? They reckon you're a living legend. But only when your mouth's closed. Any other advances on legends in the form?
Mick Gooding,
Who are we talking about? Mick Good?
Me.
Mick Good?
Ian.
Gooding. Okay.
Kirk Watts for his menagerie of sounds.
And I
menagerie of sounds? What can he do?
He can imitate anything that you like.
Go on, he
can do a great Ren and Stimpy scream.
Alright.
You can do that, he just can't do a monkey.
Oh, chimpanzee.
That hurts.
Yeah. It's not bad.
Not bad.
His strings are strings.
If I had to ask if there was a contest tomorrow night as to a personality of the year contest,
female.
Who's the female of the year for 1995, Year 10?
Belshaw. She's a clown.
Belshaw.
Laurie
Belshaw.
She's a clown.
Laurie Belshaw.
She's a clown.
She's a classic clown. Is she here to defend herself?
She's down there. I'll ask her.
Is there any other contenders for the girl of the year? Most popular girl, let's put it that way.
Gordo.
Gordon wins again. Gordo wins again.
Popular chick.
Yep.
She says she's a clown, sir.
She says she's a clown.
Okay, Michael, you brought that report back. That's true?
Yeah.
Okay.
She's just down there. She just called my name out there.
So Laurie is... all right. The male. Most popular male, 1995, Year 10.
Michael Clines.
Michael Clines. Okay. Any other contenders?
Ned
McSweeney.
Keith Thomas.
Okay.
Everyone likes Ned.
Everyone loves.
If you take that camera to every single person,
and I ask them,
every single
let me
person,
try and test this.
And you say, do you like Ned?
Do you like Ned?
Love him.
Love him.
You will not.
Do you like Ned?
Legend. Yeah.
Legend. Do you like Ned?
Definitely.
Do you like Ned? Do you like Ned? There's a problem there.
It'll never fail.
It'll never fail.
It truly is.
Just try that a bit more. Do you like? Oh, he's the living legend, Gamala! Now, Wakamali, listen, Brenda, you've got to tell me what happened yesterday. What are they all talking about? They're telling me that you did something legendary yesterday. You don't want to talk about it. I'd rather not. All right, do you like Ted McSweeney?
Yeah!
Oh, Ted. Okay, do you like Ned McSweeney?
Yeah, he's a legend.
He's a legend. Do you like Ned McSweeney? He's a legend?
Yeah.
Do you like Ned McSweeney? I've got to say to you, Mr. Gordon, that you're absolutely right.
I'll sit down.
So he is the male.
Definitely.
Okay, wait a minute.
Ned McSweeney.
Let's try this. On behalf of the teaching staff, do you like Ted McSweeney?
Yeah.
It's the beard.
It's the beard, is it? Is it the beard?
I've never known anyone in Year 10 at 16 years of age who could grow a full beard in about 3 days.
3 days. 3 days.
Now let's face it, Carl Sebastian's been trying to do it for 5 years.
Are you jealous, sir?
Ted's actually going to be a character.
Yeah.
Are you jealous?
Am I jealous?
Hey.
I wish I could transplant it.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Any other question of males that you believe should be in the legendary ranks? Apart from Brendan and Ned.
Guacamole.
No.
No, there aren't. No, no. What do you reckon, Sherry? Go away. Who's he? Is he one of our Asian students?
Lani? Some of the boys in the room.
Something
like
others?
That.
No. No contenders?
Who's
the Fred Astaire?
Mark, with blonde hair.
Mark Bellow.
He's the Fred Astaire.
What?
Because he's very good.
A dancer?
You call him one Fred Astaire. You call me Fred Astaire.
You say that to us.
You said that.
What are you doing dancing with Year 10 boys and getting them aroused like this?
So you can add
do you guys do sleazy dancing with them?
We have charisma.
Oh, the sleaze.
Right. We have charisma. So the teachers want to dance with us.
Ask McConaughey, he'll say anything. Anything's got charisma, doesn't it?
Okay, anything.
Every
Brad McConaughey, is he down here?
Pat. Matt McConaughey.
Right there. Where is he?
Right down there.
Patrick!
Charisma!
Say it again, Pat. Charisma. The man's a lunatic. Do you think the man's a lunatic?
Yeah. Sure do.
Does he believe that about himself, do you think?
What about Murray Wood? He's
probably yes.
Murray Wood.
Never talks.
The enigma.
Yeah.
Just enigma. Bring it around this way.
Bring it around this way, yes.
No, not
Jeff
this way.
Jeff Levers.
Where is that body?
Legend.
Where is that body?
Right there. Take it up the stairs. Up the stairs.
Up the stairs.
Oh, the lard.
Get us away, Jethro!
Jethro!
Hey, ladies! Give us a wave!
You're a legend! Man, he's a legend.
Let's swing it down that way towards Beth.
And who?
Beth
Beaton.
Hey, Beth!
There's Bill Shaw.
You're a legend!
Who's asked?
Which is Fred Astaire? Green shirt.
Ask Laurie.
Can we get you to dance with him?
I don't think so.
We don't think so. What? Here?
David Kingdom.
Kingdom is what?
He's an unreal rider.
He's
an extremely expressive and funny type of guy. He never lets it out in the open, but he can ride it down. It's
dead
very
set.
Funny.
Very he's
funny.
Deep waters, is he?
He certainly is. Very funny.
Very funny.
Very funny.
Okay, any other comments to make about your form, folks?
No.
No. What about Matt Tyres? Let's say.
Do we have to?
I'm asking because I know there's a vested interest up here. What do you think about the opinion that some people say he has dated everything from year 7 to year 12?
Yeah, well, it's true.
It's true.
Apart from the year 12, yeah. Year 7.
The younger the better.
Year 8.
Oh, yeah.
Why is that? So you can trade us with it.
But he is popular in the end, isn't he?
Oh.
In the end, he's popular with you guys.
No.
Not particularly.
Well, we know who he is.
Oh, well, you do know who
he is. Yeah, that's about all, though.
Okay.
He doesn't know who he is.
All right. No other votes of Miss Popularity or Mr. Popularity?
Ned McSweeney.
Ned McSweeney. I think he's going to win.
Christopher Gordon female.
I'll take the female. I'll have the female.
Miss Gordon, you'll take that?
I'll take the female.
You'll
take
any you like to do a bit of work on him.
I'll need a bit of a shave.
Beth Beaton female.
I'll tell her I look great in a skirt.
Paired eggs. Okay. Well, Miss Colette, maybe you're going to... This is Colette, isn't it? Could you offer an opinion on those legs?
On those legs?
Yeah.
Elle McPherson would be jealous.
Would be jealous.
Yeah. Elle McPherson would be jealous.
Yeah. I think you
got enough hair on there to make a coat for a silky terrier in the winter.
How do you take all of these things, Chris?
I'll take them in stride.
Let's see your stride.
Okay. All right, well, thanks for your candidness, folks. Sorry to ruin your day.
Oh, don't worry.
Through this house.
We have 8 people in our house at
eight
Mossman.
Apartments. At Mossman?
Yes. It's a penthouse.
A penthouse. Bedrooms. There's all around.
No, right, here's that's our kitchen where Gordy's going to be cooking up. There's our
house. Hey, listen, there's a guitar in the kitchen. What's that doing?
No, that's
a studio.
That's a wall.
That's a wall.
Sorry.
All right.
Come on. That's our snake pit. Indoors, of course.
Why a snake pit?
Because snakes go up ass hindy. Snakes are good, aren't they?
Snakes are good?
Don't put that on me. There's our pool. We don't have a laundry, so what we're going to do is put detergent in the pool and run around the pool.
Oh, right. Have a spa.
Shaking our clothes. Yeah, and spin dry. We're going to let the plug out and just run around it more so like you saw.
Well, maybe get a wave pool. You know, one of those continuous...
No, don't break out. It's a power idea. There's our television, but Gordy drew it upside down. It's meant to have a little...
And who's on TV?
Shirty, the slightly aggressive bear.
he's also on the door, so no one can come in.
Yeah. And right. That's really about it.
So he's your security
Sharky fish?
Gordy's shark.
Sharky fish.
Gordy, you seem to do a lot of things that are upside down or pretty
irrelevant. Oh, well, see, I was sitting over this side more doing it.
Yeah.
And I was sitting over this
side. Also,
do you have any contribution apart from the irrelevant things?
I do.
Upside down TVs.
I did the plan. My idea was the bedrooms, the pool, the haircutting kit.
Let's face it, Gordy, you've done it all.
Yeah, I suppose so, really. Yeah.
He's done it all.
Come
he's
to
just in life in general.
Mr. Jennings in the future.
But the shark's not included.
Shark's not included.
You can't get the shark.
Oh, you can't get the shark.
You can't get the batteries for it.
Right, the batteries, have you seen it?
Yeah.
Okay, sure. Thank you.
One, two, three. Mary had a little lamb. Little lamb. Mary had a little lamb. It's fleece was fine as snow. Woo!
Woo! Right. What was that exactly? What were we looking at there? The Elvis Presley?
Yeah.
Laurie, you've been already voted in as Legend of Year 10.
Yeah, she's legend. She's legend. You've got to show me
here.
They obviously want to just be on the video.
Yeah, well, that just goes without saying. They're just awful.
Anyway, this is a drink.
They're veggies.
Every time, it's not fantasy.
Nicholas, Merriman, shut up.
It sucks.
Let's say it together. Nicholas. Merriman
sucks!
Thank you. he's like an anorexic person. He thinks he's a legend. When he's really.
But you can't be a legend.
I'm really going to
go through the
whole other story.
Okay.
This is a teacher losing control.
Okay, the next one. Excuse me.
So we're going to get you back majorly.
Now, the next thing is being assertive. You understand what's related to me?
Yep.
Yeah. Wait,
no, Thursday.
Need
food.
Give me an example when you have to be assertive.
When you go for a job interview.
Getting a job.
Why, Laurie?
Oh, God.
Getting a job.
Excuse me, Laurie.
Sorry, can we get away with that thing of hiding?
That's our hammocks, because we are. We all sleep in hammocks up here, you can see. And then you go through this little glass.
What are hammocks?
Hammock?
Yeah.
It's this these big bed that hang from the roof.
Good, thank you.
And if you look over here, we've got a veggie patch inside. It's like a glass house. And then we've got this movie screen with our movie theatre. I've got one of those little electric ball things.
That's really good.
That's good.
What's in the veggie patch? Can we ask them what's in the veggie patch?
I would have at least had four televisions there because you just have to have four TVs.
Okay.
Haven't you been
one for every person? You have one for every person. Everybody's happy.
You can do it. Okay?
But that's the way I designed it. Perfect. Absolutely perfect.
That's great.
That's really good. I'll just sit down here and watch it. Can you tell me something about the glass hallway? What's it for?
It warms the inside during the winter.
Warms the inside during the winter? Okay.
Yeah.
What about the summer when you cook?
You don't really cook because
it's going to go dark.
Yeah.
Sort of have a lens.
Yep. What's the story with the lounge? Why is it shaped like that?
So it sort of makes like a little room, but it's instead of having an extra
room.
Yeah.
Okay. Now
what I do?
Okay.
Smoke.
Okay.
Yeah, just
gonna
smoke. Then go.
Now
I don't want
you. Hey, John, you want to sing it?
Get out of my
way. Hey, Kelly, do you want to sing it?
Yes, thanks. I don't smoke.
Yes, thanks. I don't smoke.
Apparently, Murray, you've been described as the enigma of the ball.
Well, have I?
Yes.
What does enigma mean?
Puzzle.
Oh.
A problem without a solution.
Oh.
Do you take that to your stride and say, oh, yeah, fair enough?
Yeah.
Fair enough?
Done my
okay. Simon, apparently you've been voted in as the most legendary male after Ned McSweeney. I think I've got to ask you, what do you think of Ned McSweeney?
Oh, to follow him, Jesus, it's not a good category to be put in.
Isn't it?
Nah, Ned's cool.
Ned's cool?
Yep. Okay. Why, who voted that?
Everyone on the other side of the wall. Yep. So you're a cool dude, apparently.
Nah, not really.
You've got degrees of coolness.
Nah.
Sound effects.
Yeah.
Okay, Ren and Stimpy number one. Okay, that's a wonderful sound effect. Any others?
It's not working.
There's another one that you've got.
I've got a chimpanzee.
Chimpanzee, yes.
Okay. Any other in a less hysterical vein?
I can do a sheep.
Do a sheep, yes.
Meh. I can do a cow.
Yeah. It's dead set.
Woof, where's the dog?
thanks, mate. I now know what they're talking about. Mr. Malone, what do you make of that? Would you call that a gibbon?
Oh, so it's a very, very good likeness of one.
Seems his ancestry is at stake here, isn't it? Well, there's Simon Cash.
This is not out of the ordinary, a Friday night.
On the floor, crawling around. Yeah.
You bet. Me and Kirk can only do.
I'm going to give you... down. Everybody down, please. Now, we've got all this area up here. I'm going to give you a little slip of paper, and on that piece of paper it's got an animal. I know there's a few animals here, but these are legitimate animals. Now, without communicating...
Well, so is this one. You can't get more legitimate.
Not that bad. Without communicating in normal means, in other words, speaking or anything, you have to, by action and by sound, try and find your partner, because there's two of each animal. Right, so you've got to crawl around the floor.
Don't you remember playing this at Brownies?
Is that right?
Guys?
No, must have missed that one.
Don't show anybody else your...
Oh, no.
Work out, it's me and Donna, work out. Have you worked out a relationship and how you live together?
Good sound.
What are you? What, have you found a part? What are these people?
Let's
hear those noises. I've seen it before. It's lost in a box. Captain. The starship.
Visor. Come on. Help me someone. Get away from me.
Thank you.
Yeah, Noosa.
Noosa?
Yep.
Ah, dear, and come to the Southern Highlands, you must have just bruised your head off, eh? No, fair enough.
Where's Mr. Mao?
Sausage.
Clean up. Okay. Well, looks like it's lunchtime. Time to feed the animals.
Sit down, Malcolm.
These are some people I haven't actually seen to have a speaking part yet. Do you want to say something, Ms. Parker?
I told him that Mr. Burns
is a
baby.
You did.
Yes, you did. Donna's put it on notice that Mr. Lurton is one of the babes. Who are the other babes? Are there any other babes?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, it's really old stuff, isn't it? That's basic.
No, there's not.
Now, what about Mr. Fisher? I mean,
he thinks he's Mr. Fisher's not bad, but not bad either. They're all ugly. Yeah. Yeah. They're
Who are the quiet achievers on these babe staff team? You know, the quiet achievers, like, you know, it might even be Mr. Carl.
We don't achieve much.
Mr. Carter, perhaps.
Mr. Tully.
Mr. Tully.
Yeah, Mr. Tully's a bit of a legend.
Right, any other ones that Ray to mention? Eleanor's already been on.
Already been on.
Yep, okay. Any other staff members that Ray to mention?
Mrs. Carl
was really helpful.
Miss Tan Chan.
Her name is Fluffy, did you realise?
Yeah,
Fluffy Corner. That's not what we have at
her. But we call them
Fluffy's Corner.
Get out! Get out of our camera.
All right.
This is legend.
Okay, well, you want to say goodbye, good night, until tomorrow night when you go to the formal?
Yeah!
Okay.
Bye!
Brush my hand.
I'm sure